this is like, this just goes to show you, like, people like, oh, Vince, you know, you're so successful at WWE and you were a failure at WCW. Oh, it's because Vince McMahon was the editor and this, that, and the other thing. Okay, Ed Ferrara comes in because, you know, it's just me and Vince writing the TV at the time. Cornette was gone. And it was like, I only got with Vince when the TV was done. So I really wanted somebody there that I could bounce things off of back and forth. Ed comes in on a trial basis immediately. He's Italian. He's from Jersey. He is probably like the smartest individual I've ever met in my life. You can't hold me down and really dot I's and cross T's. He's the detail guy. So immediately, like, I hire him. I told Vince, hire him. Which right there is something that's not in the norm in wrestling, because I should have looked at Ed as a threat, as anybody would. I would have cock-blocked him. Nah, you don't want to hire this guy. Anybody else would have done that. But I said, no, he can make the product better. He can add to the product. But I compare that to WCW, because when you look at the same set of circumstances, you know, Brad Siegel one day decides, oh, you and Eric Bischoff are going to work together. Meanwhile, Vince Russo was writing the WWE television when we wound up kicking the backsides of WCW. Eric Bischoff loses his job, and I wind up replacing Eric Bischoff.
Right.
So how Brad Siegel in his mind thought, okay, these two never met. But that's what I mean. People never want to look at the facts. But like with Ed, I was the kind of guy that, listen, man, whoever can help us make this product better, bring them on board.
From a responsibility standpoint, like, how did you two work together? Two people creatively writing music or doing anything might have two different perspectives on things. One might be stronger with this, weaker with this. What was the music you were making with Ed?
You want to hear how ridiculous this is? Okay, you look at the product today, and you know the 25, the 30 writers, whatever there is. Okay, Ed Ferrara would come to my house. We would probably start at about 10 o'clock in the morning. Okay, this is when the Jerry Springer Show was on fire.
Yeah.
Okay, Ed would come to my house in Connecticut. Springer was on like three different channels, one right after the other, like a 3-hour block of Springer. We would sit there at 10 o'clock. We would start writing the show. Springer would be on in the background, okay? We'd watch Springer till 1 o'clock while we're writing. 1 o'clock, there was a mall in Trumbull, Connecticut, right across the street from my house. Ed and I would walk to the mall and eat lunch. By the time we got back, it was 2 o'clock. We'd work from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock. Ed would leave at 5 o'clock, and we would have our show. It was that simple. At that point, we have our show. The next day, we go to Vince's house, and we pitch and lay out our show to Vince. It was that simple. How it's gone from that to 25, 30, whatever, I have no idea in the world, but we were just two guys face to face, rifting back and forth, respecting each other's ideas, being on the same page with the same goals, and it worked.
Vince obviously begins to see value in him too now, and sees you two as a team. You become friends. Well, tell me one thing that Ed was 100% responsible for that we remember, laugh at, whatever. What was What was an Ed Ferrara creation that you always admired?
God, it's hard to say because, I mean, we really did work on everything together. He was a lot like Vince in the aspect that, like, I would throw something big out there. And then Ed at that point would kind of help, you know, fine tune it and really create it to what it would become. So I can't think like off the bat of, you know, his idea or my idea. I mean, but that's how we worked.